What's going on, everybody? Mike McFarland here, the Lake Fork Guide. I'm going to give you a rundown for Tuesday, April 27th. I believe it should be the 27th still. And it is the 27th. Yes, sir. So, a little bit tired, fighting a cold. I came down with a cold on Sunday. And it kind of tipped me out a little bit. And I spent yesterday in bed, and I'm feeling a lot better. But I did fish today. And I got a little bit of information for you. So first off, before we talk on the board, he did it. Congratulations, Mr. Lee Livesay. Outstanding performance. He got to show you guys what he wanted to show you 2 years ago. Lake Fork is a beast. And now Mark Zona is even saying that it's the number one lake in the world. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. All right? The Goat Lake. It will always be the Goat Lake. It's like the quarterback, Tom Brady. Once a goat, always a goat, all right? It may have some tough seasons where it doesn't fish too well, but the century mark is made every time that the pros fish this lake. 100 pounds was broken by Mr. Lee Livesay, 112 pounds to win the four-day Bass Elite, followed up by Patrick Walters with 103 pounds. What a show. And a final day, a 42-pound sack, the third largest pound sack brought in the BASS history, all on top water. 9-pound, 8-pound fish on top water. Wow. Lee, congratulations. Man, the stars could not have lined up better. I watched you on Saturday. I watched you on Sunday on my own television from my own home. It was really special to be able to do that. You gave us a lot of really, really awesome moments, and congratulations on one of the most spectacular wins. You did us all so well. And again, you showcased Lake Fork as the Goat Lake, no doubt, okay? Let's talk about that. First of all, the lake is 403. It's full pool and holding. It's stable. The clarities are pretty good. The rain that we had last Thursday dirtied up the backwaters a little bit, but we're not fishing in them backwaters, so it's not messed us up at all. The main lake, 1 to 2 foot visibility. Water temperatures are weird, man. 61, 65. We have been sitting in this parameter for a long time. Part of it is no sun. When I said the stars lined up for the pros, hey, you know what? They are still the pros. They're still the best of the best. And they're better than you and I put together. They have to execute. But if you notice closely that on the first day, the weights were pretty good overall. The sun was shining. On day two, it went away. No sun, stormy weather. Saturday and Sunday was just the perfect conditions. Light breeze, south variable breeze, and the sun was shining. The sun is back to being obsolete. It feels like we are in, literally, I'm so tired. I feel like we're in Washington, Seattle, Washington, where the sun never shines. And it's kind of unique because typically the bass will eat really good when the sun doesn't shine this time of year. So this morning we got started. I'm ready to go catch some topwater fish. I've been telling you it's coming. The shad spawn's been trying to happen for 2 weeks now. The bass just have not finished up spawning to come out and eat yet. It's starting to happen. It's happening in the first places, the very first places that the fish spawn, up in Glade, up in Long Branch, up in Little Caney, all those places. Those fish are done, and they're coming back out starting to feed. All right, and that's what you saw those pros dominating on, mostly post-spawn fish. There were some pre-spawn mix. But, you know, we started out this morning with top water. I'm so excited. I'm thinking it's finally here. And we had a fish right away. Bam, just like that. Here we go. And, of course, no sun shining. And we didn't get any more bites. It was a tough day on Fork today. Very surprised and very disappointed. But it's weather-oriented. I watched Saturday and Sunday, and several of the elite anglers said that it was pretty unique that these fish, for some whatever reason, won't bite without sun right now. And a lot of times it's just the opposite for big, big bass. They like that rough water. They like the low light conditions. So for whatever reason, it's all about sun right now. If the sun shines, these fish bite, and they bite real well. That's all fixing to change. I'm rambling a little bit, but full moon last night, a pink moon, and those fish are busting eggs, all right? The next 7 to 10 days, you're going to have females that are finished. They're done. They're going to come back out a little bit and start to feed. 3 to 5 day recovery, and they're going to start chewing. The males are going to sit on the eggs and guard to fry for 7 to 10 days, and then they're done. All right? And it's a massive wave. There's a lot of them. When they finish and cycle out, there will be another cycle coming in to spawn. But that massive cycle that's finishing up will start chewing. We've been waiting for this, all right? It's coming. Once that happens, sunlight or not, they're going to chew. So give it a few more days. We got another round of weather coming. I think tomorrow night they're calling for up to 2 more inches of rain, which is unfortunate because we're perfect, full pool and stable. And now they're going to have no choice but to open gates. That is what it is. We can deal with that. But I just want these fish to get done spawning, get them out offshore, and get the heat on. This temperature, 65 degrees. I'm wearing a hoodie April 27th, all day long in a hoodie. Make it go away. Please bring on the heat. And the hotter it gets, the more often these fish eat. I promise you. That's my best tip right now. The baits I'm throwing is basically the same thing Olivier was throwing, at least as of today. You know, we did a saltwater spook, which is a super spook. The super spook and the saltwater spook are the same exact thing. The difference is the saltwater version comes with saltwater hooks that don't erode in the saltwater. They don't rust. Either way, they're very good. If you do the regular spook, I would change the hooks out. If you do the saltwater spook, you don't got to change them hooks. They are nasty, sharp, and they're really, really good hooks. Okay, so I like the saltwater spook. I don't worry about rusting the hooks. But I got a bait that I think is better. Reason I really like that spook is you can chuck it a mile. And if you were watching Lee, he talked about being able to stay away from the fish. They're very smart. They're very spooky. They're very aware of the boat. So the longer you can throw the bait, the farther off you can stay of where they're feeding, the better. That super spook, the saltwater super spook, man, you could chuck it a mile. I'm throwing that basically on a 7'3", 1225. I believe this is a FS, if I remember. It's an FS. F is in Frank, S is in Sam. 7'3", 1225, 50 pound braid, and Daiwa Tatula 150 with a, I think a 7 to 1. I can chuck it a mile, and it really goes a long ways. The other bait that we threw today that I really can't wait to be talking about is the Vixen. And you're going to notice that the Vixen actually has a little bit different sound. If you get your hands on a Vixen, if you can find one, you take the Vixen and the Super Spook, you'll hear the difference. The Vixen has the knock and the shh. So it's really obnoxious. It calls up the bigger bite. So between the top waters, saltwater spook or the Vixen, those are my favorite topwater choices right now. I will throw the poppers. I will throw a few other versions. The evergreen shower blows is a really good one. Generally get to those a little later in the summer. But that's the gist of what's going on. Real soon here, there should be an offshore bite beginning to develop in the shell beds. When I talk to shell beds, I'm talking the deeper shell beds. First, it'll be 12 to 16 feet. That is, in fact, the dense shell beds where there's shell on shell on shell. And you find the heart of that shell. You found the heart of the plankton where the shad come feed and the big bass come feed. And that's very prevalent throughout the lake, all the way out into 28 and 30 feet of water. The science and biologists down in Austin are studying this as we speak. I've been talking to them. There's not a lot of information on the mussel. But when we talk shell beds, folks, I'm not talking about those shallow little clams. There's real misconception. That is a shell bed. That's your shallow shell, your shallow clam bed. I'm talking about a mussel bed. And these things are extremely important to almost every body of water across the United States of America. They do make beds like oysters, absolutely 100%. These things are in Lake Okeechobee. I've had men that are 70, 80 years old call me, tell me they were fishing this kind of stuff 40 years ago. So this has been around. It's a real deal, and I'm not delusional. So Shell beds are going to come into bite here real soon. And we're going to be throwing the old football jig, the Santone 3/4 ounce football jig. We're going to get on the shaky head, the big old Magnum trick worms. We're stocked and ready to go. Look, my favorite color, African special. I'm like 20 bags deep. Tell me I ain't prepared to catch them on that. So it's coming. Can't wait. Offshore bite in the shell beds. Get with me. I got just a few openings left in June. May is almost completely full. June, you could probably get in there and learn a little bit about it. Other than that, man, having a good time here in Northeast Texas. I can hear the rain just starting to come right now, so I'm going to button this up. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. If you haven't found me on Instagram, it's The Lake Fork Guide on Instagram. Follow me there. I share daily information, daily catches as it happens. And I think I'm going to start trying to do a little bit of live. Between live Instagram, live Facebook, I'm going to come back live from time to time here as the season really does kick off, especially the offshore bite. When that gets going, we're going to be sharing stuff there. So Lake Fork Adventures Guide Service on Facebook is my business page. Other than that, give me the thumbs up. Get out there and catch you some big ones. Appreciate you watching. I'm Mike McFarland, The Lake Fork Guide.